Good morning. We're going to review your report here from Arborvita. Then we're going to throw in my septic comments too. So, okay, so we got going. This all delivered over. And then we've got, this looks good. We want to spell out Wisconsin. Make sure you spell out Wisconsin here. Good. And, yep, good. Looks good there. Yep, nice cover photo. Yeah, you can make it light sometimes, a little bit lighter, and sometimes you can change the current contrast to make it a little clearer. But anyways. It was a tough day to get a good picture on the house. So it hit okay. All right. we'll go to the meat and potatoes here. Okay, so apparently you didn't answer a lot of these. So let me just go over here. And you got your name in there. Pouch would be me. So just click there. Pump installer is Rich. He did a separate report for the well. So Iannacci certified. Home inspector, this is style of home, custom built, approximate age, let's see what the age is here. It should tell us here. Nope, they don't have the age on here. Boy, I wonder how old that house is. Let me see if we can bring it up on the website here and see if it's got a age. Sometimes they'll list it here. 2004, right there. So let's go back over here. You can put the year or just the date is fine. Okay, temperature, yeah, it was pretty good. It was below 32. Weather was snow. Radon test, yes. Well inspection, inspected. Septic inspected. And we didn't do this. So, okay. Very good. And then, so we got to go over to optional, and we're going to add in the septic. There, so now it lights up blue here, so good. So let's go back to what you got going here, and no crawl space. So I would just, instead of putting not present, I would just exclude it, and a slab, just exclude it. And so we got just the basement. Okay, lighten that up a little bit. It looks like a poured concrete wall. Yeah, some of it wasn't visible. Here, let me see if I can brighten this one up a little bit. Okay, so. Pictures are kind of dark. Not sure why. Here, let me turn my brightness up. Maybe that'll help. Looks good. All right, so let's go down to the front. Yeah, there we go. All right. Okay, there were stored items throughout the basement. Yeah. So, blocking some areas of the. Great, and good that you got pictures. You want to keep pictures. Okay. Okay. We want to kind of explain, you know, why we didn't get up in the attic wasn't selected from the hatch due to insulation. Large amount of insulation in the attic. Disturb it. Right. Okay, and then of course from here, from entry, right. Good. Okay. Exterior. Mm-hmm. Good. Using soffit. Get rid of this picture. Get rid of this picture. Yeah. Okay, let me just pause for a quick second here. Okay, so, yeah, good. Okay, door, the entrance door, storm door is in satisfactory condition. Let's back that sentence up so it's at least smooth. Okay, and then what we got here? Door at back had a damaged green, recommend repair. Mm-hmm. This is the on the lake side, I take it. Okay, so with this. And that doesn't need to be in a damaged screen doesn't need to be in a summary. Door at back door on the lakes. That's a storm door. So let me just put storm door. Back of the house. At the back of the house, lakeside. You can put lakeside at a damaged screen. Enough. Okay. This otherwise indicated. Let me see if you got anything. Okay. So we can refer, let's see, 862. Oh, window frames are, I'm just going to put exterior window frames. Okay, that's good enough. All right, then. Negative rear diagonal steps were inside of the factory condition. Yep. So we've got this gas pipe. Typically, the CSSC gas pipe should have, when it goes through a wall or a floor, they should have a black pipe. So it's something we're going to want to mention. So we'll mention that later. The rear porch and steps were in satisfactory condition. I did walk around and got a few pictures of the exterior. So I'm going to pop my pictures in here. So let me just go to get my photos. There's the septic pictures. Okay, some more siding pictures. So let's see, this is that porch. Yeah, put that picture front, second one. Yeah, we can get, if I get rid of that one. It's underneath the deck, so. Okay, so I got a picture of the gas pipe too. So let's go to plumbing. Mm-hmm. And then we're going to show that, and then we're going to go get. You got a nice picture of it, so we're going to use your picture for the exterior deck. We're going to grab this one, cut. And then we're going to go to plumbing and pop that in here. And we go down here. So they must got a wood, there's the vent for that, but I wonder, they must got a wood stove in there. So let me just go back to exterior. We'll finish this up. Yep. Yeah, and it, you know, I did see deck flashing here. It's kind of hard to tell. But there's a little strip there. Let me see if I can pull it up here on your photo. I think you had a pretty decent photo of it. Right here, let me see. Yeah, there's like a metal strip that runs all the way across here. Yep. All right, let's see. Okay, let me see. If mine shows it too. Always look for that metal strip. It's kind of right here. You can barely see it, but they got a screen over this too, but there's a little metal strip that runs behind that. Now, I didn't see it on the deck. But anyways, so the porch and steps were in satisfactory condition. Which would be, okay, good. Well, that's actually the deck over here. Let's see. Yeah, so that's the rear deck. Okay, so the steps were part of the deck. So I'm going to move that over there. This is this porch here, so I got a nice picture there. Always stand back from and try to side and get a nice view there. And there's the steps, so we'll move that there. We'll move that picture up a couple, move up one, so that, move up one. So we got, let me move that to the back. So we got, move that to the front. There we go. So we got the overall, the close-up of the steps. Show them the railings. So I'm not sure if we actually need this or not. This picture here shows a lot of snow on there. Whoa. A lot of snow. I wonder if they had something. They must got furniture. So a hot dog. I don't know what they got. So we'll leave that. It shows a lot of snow on there. Underneath looks good. Okay. So. What we want to do is use snow covered. Right here, snow covered. The deck was snow covered, but appeared well supported. The deck should be further better when snow is removed. There you go. So we can say deck and steps. Or snow covered. There we go. Good. And then the rear porch was satisfied and well supported. Yep. Good. Get rid of that first one there. Yeah, it's hard to get around that house, right? Good. Good, you did catch those shingles. Good, good job. Always explain where it's located. Shingles covering covering flashing. The wall on the lakeside of the home above the deck where loose was loose. Okay. I did take a couple just overall pictures like this one here. That's a nice one showing all the snow. I don't know if I got any more. Yeah, so that one looks good. That shows a lot of snow up there. I got the chimney too, and I'm sure you did. But so, okay. All right, flashing. Mm-hmm. Well, you got a good picture. Yep, good. It was a terrible day out there. Okay, so, yeah, so we'll just leave it at that. It was not expected. All we can do. Good. We could assume there's only one layer of shingles because the house is 2004, you know, so. What to say appears to be one. Yep. Okay. Okay, so because there was a leak right here, we don't want to say, so you got to edit this. Overall, no visible leaks, but there was a leak, so we can't say that. With no blockage, unless otherwise. Oh, I see. Unless otherwise, yep, indicated. So you're right. So let me go back. I should have read the whole thing. Yeah, no visible leaks. We could just say no visible leaks or blockage unless otherwise indicated. Good. There we go. Yep. Good. Okay. Signs of leaks. Signs of leak at sewage lift pipe. Okay. Dry at the time of the inspection during use. Yep. Monitor. Yep. Okay. Yep, good. Great. Yep. Okay. Rich got this in his report, so I'm just going to exclude it here. He included it with his well, so since he didn't have a pitch. If he had a pitch, I would have left it. But good. You need to make sure those are bonded. Good job. Okay. Yeah, so let me move this one first since it's the first pitcher coming out of the wall, and then you got this one going up. Okay, so not a big deal. I don't put it in the summary. I do mention it, though. Yeah, so, and the reason why is they want black pipe, rigid pipe, is so it doesn't bend. So if somebody kind of moves it, it can bend it and increase it or whatever. And I'm not sure what this is even hooked to. Let's see what we got here. Was there a gas log somewhere? Was there I'm not sure if there, what was in that room that had the porch. Here's the vent for it. Was that just an air vent? I don't know what that, okay. I guess I should have looked. I didn't go in that room, so maybe you'll have a picture of it. So we'll just come back to that. Okay, so where were we? Plumbing. Okay. Did they have propane or natural gas there? I'm trying to think. Let me see what you got here. Natural gas. Okay, I didn't see a picture of the meter. I don't know if I've got a picture of the meter or not. And all of my shenanigans. I had one picture over here. I don't know what happened to it. Well, my camera was not working too well that day. Okay. Anyways. So we got it. There's natural gas. Oh, there it is. Yeah, good. Pretty good. Yep. Always make sure these are vented and sealed. Good job. All right. So, not sure what this pipe is going to here. Well, maybe we'll figure it out. Okay. Yep. Good. Yep, good. And then there's sub-panel. The sub-panel is located in the basement. Closet. Off the bar. Access was blocked by gun cabinet and panel was not inspected. Yeah. Yep, good. Alrighty. Good. 200 amp. We got unusual misconnected bottom panel. How's that look there? Should be tightened up. They just need to tighten it so the hose not there. They got wires there. Look like maybe they had a something going on there. But so anyways, they just need to be tightened up so the hole is closed off. Ooh, I got to downsize that. Okay. So let me just. Or knockout plugs can be inserted. Okay. Nice. Okay, mostly cold, like a minute. Okay, I like that comment. Recommend upgrading exterior bulbs to cold compatible LED. I didn't know they had such a thing. Okay, all exterior receptacles tested with GFC evidence and were functional in use with in use covers. Okay, good. All right. Good, good, good. Great. Okay, basement bar receptacle was not grounded, but with GFC, I recommend electrician. Okay, so basement bar receptacle were not grounded, but with GFC, well, the one was. The one to the left of the bar was. The basement bar receptacle to the left of the sink was GFCI. Was GFCI, was a GFCI, a grounded GFCI. The bar, basement bar receptacle to the left of the sink was a grounded GFCI. Yeah. Outlet. Was a grounded GFCI outlet. Let me just get rid of the but. There were two ungrounded outlets that were Yeah, they need to be grounded. Yeah, so very good. Okay. And then we've got. Yep, good. Yep. You got to explain a little bit more, Michael. Okay, there we're. At least two loose wall receptacles. One on the main floor and one on in the basement. Outlets should be properly secured. Yep, so. Three-way switch for main staircase did not function properly. Recommend further evaluation and repair. Huh. Good catch. Good. Make that a standalone sentence. So I always try to put the main the main floors first, then the bars. But we didn't mention about the other bathroom. Oh, you got those here. Very good. Great. There we go. So let's go over here. Do you have to, basement bathroom receptacles were ungrounded and were lacking GFCI protection. Yeah. Oh, they just need to add it. I like that comment. Good. Okay. Kitchen area. Oh, I see. Okay. You're putting the location right here. So you might have done that in the over here. Yeah, with your other comment. So maybe you did. Okay. I see how you're doing it. So let's go over here. Yeah. Good. I like to put it in the sentence here, so. Okay, so we go over here. Okay, good. So, I mean, I do have this comment here, this first one here. So. To a combination unit test. Mm-hmm. So. Yeah. Okay, so we do got the standalone comment here, right here. So we want to use that one all the time when there's a furnace, you know. So let's go, let me just open that back up and edit this. I'm going to make sure. So click that right there. So when you go back to your report, Mike, just open up that comment. Let me just show you how I did it. Yes. Okay. So just open up the report. There it is. Highlight it. Hit the wrench here. And then make sure this is checked. Automatically include. Okay. So you want to do that. And then you want to hit okay. And then it's going to automatically include that comment next time. So. But it's a standalone, so no pictures with this. It just stands alone by itself. Kind of like the electrical one here. This one's a standalone comment by itself. So that's basically just the same thing with the furnace. Make sure you get this standalone comment. Yep, so this is good for this one. Now, sometimes you got to edit this because sometimes it's an older one and there's no draft, you know, draft fan. There's a flue, but no draft fan. So make sure you always edit this. You just don't click on it and run by it. You know what I mean? So, all right. Right. Very good. Put a period. Great. Good. Okay. Good. Man, I thought I had pictures of that pipe. Man, I did. I don't know what happened to all my pictures. Let me see. here it is, right here. There's something. I think this was the furnace, the water heater. So let me just put it here, furnace. Okay. Let's put this one first. There you go. So you show the nice picture first, and then you get into the nitty gritty here. So. For cleaning, just add that in there. Okay. So we can go in here and edit this. This is what you need to do on your computer. And just put in for cleaning. And then hit save and it should be in there. Good. All right. Five years on that furnace. What that water heater? 14 years. Yes, yeah, so that's the original. They must have replaced that furnace. Okay. Interesting. Maybe it wasn't big enough. Okay, air conditioning. Yep, there's that standalone common for the AC. Yeah, so because we did inspect it, I don't include this one, so I just delete it. But if you inspect it, I mean, if it was warm enough where you could test it, then you would leave that in there. But since we didn't test it, we don't need that comment. Yep, good. Put that one first, front. Back one, good. Okay, great. Yeah, I just when we don't test it, I just don't do nothing there. So okay, good. Good. Laundry room, upstairs bathroom. Good, good. I see you. I see where you explained your locations. That's good. Good job. Okay. So, prepared by Glazer. Well, not sure. Let me see what we got here. Okay, so the fogging. There we go. Okay, here's the comment that I like using right here. So let me just get rid of this comment here. So okay. So you can take this comment and just kind of add it, just make it over here a standalone, and then you can add it in there. Or a change of weather. Yeah, I like that part. Copy. And then hit it, save. So this is a good comment, because it could be fine today, and tomorrow it could be a change in weather, and you could start spotting up with moisture. Okay, good. Okay, so this is where I got to go get the pictures from Rich. So let me put you on. I'll pause for a second. Okay, Mike. So I just moved that comment over. And added the pictures in there, so very good. Okay, insulation, yep, great. Awesome. In the visible areas, you wanna add that. I mean, it could have been vented through the roof and we just couldn't see it. I mean, I couldn't see anything. So, yeah, I mean, it's a possibility, Mike, that they were vented, you know, somewhere. I tried to look for vents. I couldn't see it. It was so hard to see. So, okay, so let's go back to here. I thought I had one vent. I hit a vent right here. This is the basement bathroom right here. Yeah, we don't know if they're vented into the attic. I doubt very seriously that they're vented into the attic, but we don't know. So, but I, you know. So we're just going to say recommend further evaluation when weather permits. But it could not be determined. It could not be determined where they were vented. Where they were vented due to the snow on the roof and the weather conditions at the time of the inspection. Good. All right.
All systems go?
Yeah.
Fruit? Let me get it going.
Okay. Couldn't tell what it was, eh? Okay. Yeah, okay. True. Okay, so let's go. I thought we already, did we address this over here? Ooh, right here, maybe. I wonder if that's vented outside. So let's just refer this over here. Okay. Okay, so we'll put it in the summary over here. Yep. Washer and dryer were not inspected. Did they have clothes in them, or what was the reason why they weren't inspected? They're not staying with the house. Just wondering why you didn't inspect it. Usually we want to say why they were not inspected. Because typically we will test them, unless there's clothes in them. So just kind of need to know. Good. Let's see what we got going here. No railing. Yeah. So we could just make a note. just leave it at that. We're gonna make a big stink out of it. I take it the garage was part of the drywall too, firewall. So. Right here, that one. Nice. Good. Great. Awesome. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and just review. Well, before I do that, let me just go ahead and see what pictures I've got here. Don't need that one. It's the front porch. Let me see if you submitted anything about the front porch. Rear porch. So let me go to the front porch. Let me add this picture in here. Bibs. I guess I can do that a little better. I'm gonna do that a little better here. I got off course there. There we go. Did I have another one on this with this other picture? Right here, was that a hose bib? Yeah, right here's another one. Okay, that's a good soffit. Maybe we could replace that one that you had. This one. Let me get rid of that one and replace it with this one. There we go. And then we can also. I like. You got a nice picture there of the vent right here. Copy. We can go over here and. Snow covered. Okay, so let's see what other pictures I got here that we could add siding. How'd your siding picture look? Pretty good. We could add this one maybe. And this vent. I didn't see you mention the vent. Not sure what this vent is. I may have to call you on a few of these questions here. this here, let me go to Windows. There's a little, I don't know, it looked like they got some kind of probably what do you call them, the tint, it's like a they stick it on the window, like a, it's like a tint, it tints the window, but it looks like the stick on, oh, what do you call it, a stick on tint for the window, looks like it was loose around the edges here. Let me research this a little bit. Okay. Yeah, it's hard to tell what that is. Let me go to my pictures here and blow them up and see what you think. See, it looks almost like it's a stick-on. See how it's kind of like loose on the edges here, here, and here. This board's got some wide cracks in it too, and I wanted to mention that. So. Yeah, so let's go back to the report here. Okay. Should be easy. Good. And we'll just put out an AV there. Yeah, very good. All right. Let me run through my photos. I think all my photos are used up now. Good. All right. So let's go to the septic and pop in my photos for that. Here's the it was when I was done, I covered it back up with snow to keep it from freezing. Yep. So. That's that effluent filter, so put that over there. That's the drain field. Let me create a new comment for the drain field.
Septic tank is flowing to the drain field after a 30 plus minute test. Effluent filter in the outlet backflow should be cleaned once a year, pulled out and rinsed off with a garden hose.
Okay, oop, I put that in the wrong section. Cut. Let me just delete that. Open, check, and then cover it back up. Okay, and then we got going here. That's the filter. And we can put this right here. We'll just put it here. Sometimes I put it with the septic system here. Okay, good. So I'll go over here, and I think this is the first one is the one we want here. Functional flow test was performed on the way. We should have a comment here about the drain field. The inspection event placed over the drain field were not present due to covered with snow and was not located. So the thing was inspected through an excess cover and function probably. Time inspection, the scum layer center and effluent was well within limits. There was an effluent filter in the outlet baffle inside the septic tank. The filter should be pulled out and cleaned annually. Recommend rinsing off with a garden hose. Good. All right, so let's go. Let me. Oh, what it says? Oh, we got to go here to styles and materials. Let me see if we got the permit on that. Let's see. Septic permit. And tell us, it should tell us what size tank and all that is. Okay, so we get 1,250 gallon tank. Okay. Yep, okay, good. Go back to 1,250. Where is it at? We don't have a 1,250 in here. All right, so let's go add. Nope, I'm sorry. Cancel. Edit. And we're going to add 1,250 gallons. Then hit the ABC, and then it throws it up in the numerical order or alphabetical order. There it is. Great. Okay, above ground access lid. Yep. Yep. Good. Try next. Let's get rid of that comment there. Try next. We can get rid of that comment there. Try next. All items have been answered. Very good. So let's go to upload and review. Some repairs on the electrical. That's about it, though. Okay, what was I thinking? Oh, I had a thought. Oh, the basement door. Okay, that Bilco door. We didn't say nothing about that Bilco door, but I know you had it under structural, I think. Basement, let's see. Right here. Always want to make sure you look at the floor of this. Make sure it's concrete and dry. We had one over, I don't know, in Winchester or someplace. Anyways, water was getting into this thing, and it was causing a lot of problems. There was no concrete here on the floor, and it was wet and pooling water. Water's leaking in, so you always want to make sure you check the bottom underneath these steps to make sure that that's nice and dry in there, okay? Okay, good. Great. All right. So I think I did have a few questions. So let me just pause this. I'm going to call you. Okay, so I just got off the phone with you. So this is the vent for, where did that vent go? Right here. So that's the vent. Okay. There's a grill. Okay, there was a vent fan in the lakeside porch room, in the lakeside porch by the gas grill. An exhaust fan, let me call it. There was an exhaust fan, vent fan. Good. Awesome. Okay. And I guess that's about it. So let me just kind of cruise through here real quick. Yeah, I might put this outside picture over here to the first spot, outside and then inside. Usually that's my kind of my stupid method of doing things, but I like to keep them in order. So we started outside and now we got the inside. Good. Let me just, I just wanted, I was thinking about this basement moment. One of the short signs of Boeing and appeared to be cosmetic. In the basement. Basement panel walls and bathroom showed signs of Boeing. Yeah, okay. That's good. All right, so. Electrical. Great. Okay, so let me cancel that for now. All right, good job, man. I'm gonna kill this.